tonight at 10. There's a young woman about to graduate from Pattonville High School who is making waves across the area.
Her goal is to inspire children to know they can do whatever they put their mind to, and they listen because of the challenges she conquered growing up.
I love all science classes, so human anatomy, physics, AP bio, those are my favorite classes. I also love math, so I really like school.
At first glance, Madeline Hubbs is your typical teen.
Snapchat, Instagram, yeah.
Enjoying life and anxiously awaiting the end of her senior year.
I'm super excited to start at Maryville and study occupational therapy and meet new people and live on campus.
And her mother knows Madeline has the drive to succeed.
She is a go-getter, unstoppable. That is true from being born 10 weeks early, unstoppable.
She faced setbacks at the start of her life.
It was a big shock. My husband and I actually didn't have anything because she still had at least 10 more weeks to go.
But her family says Madeline has always gotten back on the horse when any sort of health problem tried to get in her way. But her chosen sport during the spring season still had mom worried.
It's a little scary sometimes and with water polo because it is a co-ed and can be kind of a rough sport that is out there, even for just a girl, let alone a girl with one arm.
That's right. Madeline plays water polo with only one arm.
In the beginning, it was hard for me because it was a lot more upper body strength than swimming because you have to keep your head up out of the water and use your arm. But my coaches were really accommodating.
It was awesome to have Madeline in the pool because she goes just as hard as anyone else does in the water.
My coach sometimes has to be like, Madeline, settle down.
She's coming to the end of her senior season. Her playing style has given no concession at all to playing with just one limb.
Feisty. She gives no quarter, and she doesn't expect any in return.
That feisty attitude was formed as she grew up dealing with the challenge of being the girl in the class with only one arm.
There has been a few times where things have happened that were hurtful. When she was in kindergarten, she came off the bus nearly in tears, and I could tell something was wrong.
Now Madeline takes those hard-fought lessons and speaks to elementary students about bullying and acceptance.
You know, we're all different in our own unique ways. Just some of us might do things a little bit different than others. I'm just living my life with one arm. I mean, my legs are a lot stronger than my one arm that I do have. So any power that I do have comes from my legs. And I'm just living an everyday normal life.
Since shortly after birth, Madeline has been learning how to do things differently at Shriners Hospital for Children.
There was nobody else that we could turn to until we got to be connected with Shriners Hospital.
Now she spends her time giving back to Shriners.
But to me, it's meant more than just the medical side of things. They've really given me my confidence to go out and try whatever I want to do, such as swimming and water polo.
Her and I feel like that's our job now, is to take what we've learned and make life a little bit easier for these parents. And these children that have limb differences.
I want to be inspiring to other kids that have disabilities, and maybe they're sitting on the stands and they think, well, I can't do that, but in reality they can. As long as you have that little fire inside of you that gets you going, I think that's what makes you determined and makes you passionate about something.
Madeline will attend Maryville University in the fall to study occupational therapy. She says she wants to help other kids overcome obstacles like she has, and I really enjoyed meeting Madeline and her mom. Her positive spirit is really infectious. Yeah. If you're around her for 2 minutes, you're inspired.
Yeah.
And I think she's going to go on to inspire more people. It's like a ripple effect across the community, right?
I see what you did there. Ripple. Pool, water.
Yeah, I didn't even put two and two together. Nice.
You're too smart for your own good.
You're quicker than me.
Steve.
You know that. Today.